Hello, and here I am again with the next video on my request list. Now, this person asked for a life path two, and I've put 202 because there really is only one type of life path two. There's three elements to a date of birth. So of course you can't have a life path just two, because even if you add one on each, it would come to three. So you can't have a life path two on its own. You can have a 202, which makes one life path, which is really a very intense, intuitive, service-driven number in the two. And all the other numbers have several types. The life path two is just the 202. When you're looking at the two in terms of expression numbers, yeah, if you have two names, it's very possible that your first name could be count up to one and your surname to two, to one as well, which makes just two. And then your talent focus is just on the energy of the two. But life path wise, there is only one type, and that is the 202. So that makes life path twos quite rare, because you've got types with all the other life paths. Anyway, I digress. The life path 202 is the most important number on your chart. It's the reason you came to this lifetime. It's your path of challenge. So a lot of things that I'm about to say aren't going to come easy to you. But what will help or hinder you at certain elements of your life path is your fixed talent number. And that was given to you when you were born. That's the energy of your full birth name. And that's given you quite a powerful expression number, which is the nine, the talent of the nine. Now, both of these numbers are very service orientated. The two is about being gentle, compassionate, nurturing, being empathetic, understanding people's needs before they do. It's a very gentle, nurturing soul, and that's what you're here to be. But you have the talent of the teacher, the influencer, the very strong person of the energy of the nine, which is very much the spiritual teacher, the influencer. Sometimes when overworked, the fixer of other people's lives, and that needs to be brought to boundaries. So both these numbers are about helping people. They're about service. The nine's going to make you over help as well as the two. And sometimes with that strong expression nine, you might struggle to achieve the gentleness and the connection, because nines can be quite, I like everyone, I don't connect with any one person fully. And the two is saying connect with some people fully. So there's going to be some situations where you're more distant than you should be, and you need to start connecting on a deeper level, especially with those you intuitively trust and those that have your best interests at heart. So as a two, you're all about your relationships and pulling people close and serving their needs. Now, the nine is good at serving needs, but it might struggle to pull people close. And you'll see as we look at what you're here to do, look at what you've got, and then we start breaking down the elements of the life path too, you'll start to see what I mean amongst other things. So let's have a look. First of all, you're a life path 202. There is only one. So your areas of development and things to achieve in this lifetime, remember, these aren't things you're going to find easy, okay? To build close relationships, to cooperate in a close-knit family group or team, it's just a group of people. And for many, it's actually the family that is your closest. Then you might have a close group of friends or a team that you work with quite closely and that you trust. You're here to actually serve their needs, but with boundaries. Be responsible, to be depended upon by the team, the group, the family, to be able to stay focused on things and plan effectively for the team, to keep the cogs moving, to keep things going for the team. Very much team player, team building. You make sure everything's running smoothly for all and everyone. And you often do it from the background, because you don't need to be on the stage. You're very much service in the background. You're like the cogs in the wheel that make the show happen, and the show wouldn't happen without you. And you're often you miss the accolades, and often people take your accolades because you're not up front to take a bow, or they're quite happy to take what you've done and say it was them that did it, which can anyway can be quite upsetting for a two. But anyway, You're here to plan effectively for the team, keep things running smoothly in the background, but have boundaries and, you know, make sure you're not walked upon and ignored by others. Make sure that, you know, you acknowledge yourself internally, first of all, for the contribution you make, you know, otherwise you're going to become resentful and upset. And, you know, you want to have your own, you don't need other people to say thank you. You want to develop towards the ability of knowing the contribution you make without needing to have people say thank you to you, because many too struggle with that. They give and they give and they give, and they often don't feel that people are giving them the acknowledgement or thanks that they would expect for the service that they give. And as you develop as a two, you'll feel less need acknowledgement from others. You'll know in your heart the difference that you make to this world without needing someone to say thank you or you're amazing. You know in your heart. You're here to develop your intuitive skills to help you assess the needs of others and understand their needs more than they understand themselves, and so that you can make inner decisions, so you can look inward for validation and not think about what other people in the world say. You know, go inward for validation, go inward for the final decision on your decisions and your actions. You know, and as well, you're here, remember, fundamentally to develop your relationships, and that includes your long-term relationships. You've got to develop a healthy need for love, and that means, you know, with boundaries, of course, with everything, because you're a two, you've got to have boundaries to how much you give. But a healthy need for love means it's not smothering. And it's not being distant, it's being present when you need to be with your family. When you're doing your own thing, you're doing your own thing. When you're with your family, your team, your friends, you are present with them. But you're not over, you know, some twos can be over smothering and some twos can be really distant and struggle to develop that closeness. And you want to find that middle point, because this is going to help you with your long-term relationships hugely, because you need to have that healthy need for love as part of your purpose so that you can keep together a long-term relationship and keep it harmonious with healthy boundaries for your well-being, to make sure you're giving and receiving in equal measure, and social skills, tact, the ability to mediate the group, and the ability to work one-to-one with someone and develop their trust, whether as a client or a friend or a member of the family. You're here to be that person that people can go to for intuitive advice and compassion and care and service and support. You know, that's the two energy. It's very gentle, it's very compassionate, and it needs to make sure it's not stepped on, you know, and that it's gentleness isn't stepped on. But you're not going to have to worry about this so much, because you've got the expression number nine. The expression number nine makes me sit up straight. It's the powerful nine. It's the strong intuitive wisdom of the sage, the spiritual teacher. Very idealistic, but when you're a talent nine, you don't put your ideals first, you go intuitive first, because you know as a nine that our ideals aren't always possible or realistic or healthy. You know, you have to make sure that what you feel that is ideal for the world actually is for everyone and not like for some and not others. You know, this really needs to be thought about by a nine, because nines are powerful, and whatever they project into the world, it's going to have an impact. It can either lead people to well-being or it can crush them over the edge of the cliff. Like the sect leaders that, you know, influence their people all to commit suicide or do horrific things. That's the negativity of a powerful nine. They've got the power to influence and teach, and everyone listens to a nine, but you're a talented nine, so you're an ethical communicator. You focus on your ideals, so when you teach, everyone listens to you. You're ethical and responsible, you act with integrity, and you improve the well-being of others. A life path nine might struggle with, sometimes they might not improve the well-being of others. Sometimes they might cause the upset of others, and they need to learn not to do that. But you're a talented nine, so you're already good at improving the well-being of others. You're very humanitarian, excellent communicator to influence, a leader. but a supportive leader, the kind of leader that leads by example. So this is a very practice your preach wisdom kind of influence and leadership. The counsellor and the advisor. So again, that's going to support the two. But the expression number 9 is powerful and sometimes doesn't suffer fools gladly and can sometimes hide their heart from the people around them or spread their heart too thin. Because remember, 9s fix everyone's life sometimes and they want to help everyone. And, you know, whether near or far, a 9 doesn't care whether you're near or far, you're a human being and they want to improve your well-being. And that can make it a bit difficult. The 9 then becomes a bit distant with the people that they love most. And this could be the crux for this combination. Anyway, let's stop gabbling and break this bad boy down. So you're here to learn to be responsible to others in the team. Very basic. To think about what you do and the consequences of your actions and make sure that it's responsible and that you have balanced responsibility, that you're not doing too much or doing too little. You know, you've got to find that balance between the two. You can be over responsible and like smother people and like exhaust yourself, or you can be totally irresponsible. And if you're too responsible, you can start feeling resentful and undervalued, especially if you haven't got that inner acknowledgement of the difference you make. Because remember, you shouldn't need acknowledgement from others. You should know internally the difference you make. But this is the development of a 2. They can really think, you know, why aren't people more thankful and, you know, treat me better for the things that I do? And they, you know, you're here to get past that and not feel that resentment and know internally, I make a difference in this world. The way I express my balanced responsibility to others makes a difference. And that's all you should need. And, you know, you're going to have to develop towards that, okay? And that's nothing off your back. That just means that's one of your development points. I've got development points. Remember, we've all got development points. And I'm still working on mine. But your 9 talent energy makes you able to leave a legacy of health and wellness. It's very powerful. It can often overpower the energy of the 2, which is very much about focusing on that connection, that deepening of that trust that 2 people have, and the balanced responsibility, the care for yourself as well as those around you. I mean, wellness and responsibility do go together, but don't let the 9 overpower that. But the 9 always acts with integrity and responsibility. That's a tick for the life path 2, because all your actions and beliefs will be filtered through your intuitive wisdom. And there's the crux. The talented 9 is oodles of intuition. And that's exactly what the life path number 2 needs, not only for their inner compass and validation, but to help them assess the needs of others as a person that is here to serve. But you've got 2 service numbers making 70% of your core numbers there. You could end up being a fixer of everyone's lives. First of all, being a fixer, you're stopping them from, you know, making their own mistakes. So in you're not disrupting their life path. If you're a fixer, you can't fix their lives. You might want to help everybody, but you're going to exhaust yourself. You're going to ignore your own needs. I mean, if you're fixing everyone else's life, you ain't developing your own life path. And they've got to develop their life path, and you've got to develop your life path. And think of that every time you feel that you're, you know, you're spending too much time with any one person, or they're relying on you too much. You know, you're not here to fix their lives. You're here to give them the tools that they need so that they can run their own lives. And then you can spend time on your own life. You know, you're not just here to serve others. There's got to be boundaries and balance here. So support your life path too by making the people in your team and your family and the people around you, those that you want to deepen relationships with, your top priority. But balance that responsibility to them and have boundaries to how much you will do and how much you will let them expect from you and how much, you know, you take from them. Because, you know, remember, as a 2, you can swing from over responsibility to under responsibility. As a nine talent, you're more likely to be over-responsible, do too much, because remember, you're a talented fixer if you allow yourself to be. So keep that in mind. Boundaries are very important. The boundaries of the people you're working and connecting with, but also your own boundaries for your own development. You know, you can't live your life in the shoes of others. It's not helpful to them, and it's certainly not helpful to you. You've got to learn to improve your social skills. You're here to help others, to counsel them, and they've got to be able to trust you and listen to you. So improving your social skills, especially those for the one-to-one, the pulling people close, not just widening your relationships, but deepening your relationships so that you can develop trust and make decisions, both of you, more subjectively, not objectively. You're here to be more subjective. And it's important that you deepen your relationships and connect one-to-one with certain people in your life, your family, not just one person, but your family, the people that you intuitively trust, because this is a crux. Not everyone deserves your love, life path two. And you can have a tendency at times to pull everyone in and you want to help every waif and stray, but not everybody has your best interests at heart, and not everybody deserves your caring and love and compassion. Treat what you give as a gift that you only give to those that you feel intuitively need it the most, and most importantly, those that have your best interests at heart too, not those that are going to take from you like a sweetie jar and then make you feel like rubbish. And this is something twos go through, especially with a fixer talent like the nine. You know, you give and you give and you give to others, and some people didn't deserve that. And you're going to learn that lesson when they treat you how they treat you, and only you know how that's manifested in your life individually. So deepening your relationships, being more intuitive, only giving your help, your concern, your connection, your trust to those you feel intuitively close to and that have your best interests at heart. It's about knowing who to pull close and who to keep that little bit further back, you know. Your nine talent energy means that you have the abilities of all the numbers. You're quite generalist, you're multi-skilled, charismatic, very outward, you know, the influencer. Everyone listens to a nine. Very powerful talent. Your life is your teaching. You speak richly. That people hang on your every word. You're social, emotional, passionate, and you love to laugh. But there's a certain distance there. And the two is about pulling people closer. So you can use your talents of the nine in order to pull people to a certain level. But fundamentally, there's still potentially a certain distance there. As a nine, you spread your care to the masses. You've got to deepen those relationships, not just broaden them. Broaden is there, yes, because you're here to communicate and influence as many people as possible. But your issue is going to be bringing those key trusted people close and to deepen your relationships. And you might find that actually often you have a bit of a, you know, a front, a cold front where you push people backwards. And that's just part of your purpose to develop that, to let down your guards to those that need it, to those that you trust, not to those that maybe don't have your best interests at heart. And that's going to be the crux of the situation for you. You've got to balance your need for love, as I said right at the beginning, so that you don't smother your loved ones, do too much for them, give them ideals and situations that they couldn't possibly achieve, you know, and really have expectations of them. You know, this is members of your family or team. This is a smother situation. Or you could go the other way up totally and be totally distant and feel disconnected from love. And it can be that, you know, you feel that it makes you feel weak, especially as an expression nine. You know, you might at times sort of hide your heart a little bit and be a bit more distant. So as a talented nine, you may feel often like you're more the distant side of the coin. But both of these numbers are idealistic too. So both have the tendency to smother or be distant, okay? And remember, you need to have a balance there in order to develop healthy relationships. You need a healthy need for love to develop your healthy relationships. And that is really important element of your life path too. You're here to learn, as I keep going on about, to be intuitive and sensitive to the needs of others, and also to be of service to the needs of others, to develop intuition so that you can read people. And not only that, you need to take your validation from within, not from people around you, not from naysayers, not from well-meaning family members even, because, you know, people are well-meaning at the end of the day and they often project their fears out on you. So if they're giving you unsolicited advice and saying what you should and shouldn't do, go within. You know, you don't have to blame them for that. They probably, maybe, maybe not, remember, have your good interests, best interests at heart. But you're here to go inward for validation. You can take what they say into account. You can take all the elements into account in the world that you see before you, but you filter that through the intuitive voice within and come up with your own decisions, your own actions throughout your own inner compass. And that will help you even more to trust the soul within you when you're assessing the needs of others. You're going to know what people need and what healing they need when you use your intuition fully, better than they do. And the talent of the nine gives you a natural propensity to intuition. So that's a big part of your path. Nailed, man. You're very intuitive, but you just got to trust it and use it. And that's going to be confidence or other elements in your life that is going to block that or make that move forward. So your actions are often filtered naturally through your intuition in order for you to be of service to other people. So the nine can be quite helpful there when it comes to intuition. But take care not to lose your connection with your intuitive wisdom or make decisions or justify your actions via things that happen in the world, perceived injustices against you or worldly ideals or social convention and laws. That's not what you're about. You're here to look to the spiritual. Always go to the intuition. If something don't feel quite right, you've got to go back within and find out what it is about that that isn't right. Never act if it doesn't feel or seem, however your intuition is fed to you, if it doesn't feel right, if it doesn't sound right, if it doesn't, you know, if it's something wrong there, don't do it until you are intuitively sure of your actions. So support your life path too by accessing and developing your intuition that is there already, and use it to access what you can do for others and your own intuitive voice within. This is really important for you. You need to do it for your life purpose, and you've got all the talent you need to do it, and it will make a huge difference to your life, your ability to connect with others in general when you walk this path of improving and trusting your intuition. You're all about people as a life path too. It's all about your relationships, to not only be a family member and cooperate within a family, but to be a team player, to get the job done as part of a cohesive team, group or family. It's a collective, you know. And because you're a two and you're here to be cooperative and collective minded, you can be a bit emotional, disruptive and a bit of a drama queen at times. And sometimes you can struggle to work in a group or family situation. And there could be multiple specific reasons for that, but it's part of your path to get through these difficulties. Your talent in the nine energy, you can be a team player. The nine talent already gives you those good social communication skills, and you're able to pull your weight in the team. In fact, at times you might try and lead a little bit when you're really supposed to be just cooperating in the team, and you will try to lead and influence, but you might find that your team members actually welcome that at times because of the energy of you. They trust you to know what you're talking about, so they may unofficially treat you or see you as the leader because of your wisdom and guidance. But you're here really to work as part of the team, the group, and to take more of an equal footing, cooperation, team player kind of role. You tend to take charge a little bit. You are emotional as a nine, strong-minded, stubborn. You don't suffer fools gladly, but you're a talented drama queen. So there's the rub. You've got the tendency in the life path too to be a bit of a drama queen. And then your talent in the nine, because you could be a thespian. A talented nine could be a thespian, like a three. So they can be a bit of a drama queen by okay, and if you have a tendency by life path too, maybe you need to, you know, keep in mind that you can be a bit of a drama queen, and to think about your emotional impact on others and how that affects you and what the triggers of that emotionality is. Because maybe you're not thinking about the impact of that drama queen mentality on the family, the team, the group. And that's not a judgment. That's just part of your life path to improve like anyone else. We've all got different issues to walk through. So support your life path too by understanding the whole team. The whole team has something to offer. And so do you. You're part of one collective. And that you need to cooperate in the spirit of service, cooperation and temperance of your drama queen tendencies, because you're conscious and mindful of your impact, your emotional impact on others, and you're always listening and assessing how you react emotionally to those around you, what the triggers are, which helps you uncover beliefs and, you know, sometimes unhealthy beliefs that could be causing emotionality that feeds the drama queen tendency. Anyway, service, cooperation, the spirit of being around other people and being able to cooperate. But you're here to be gentle, service orientated, and people can think that you can be walked upon. So you're also here to develop the assertiveness to not only understand your own contribution to the world without needing accolades from others, and feel that you are strong and of service, and to feel that within, that you make a difference, but also to demand boundaries, to being overworked, walked all over, taken advantage of. You know your value when you're at full development, so you're not going to allow yourself to be taken for granted. You're not always chasing those accolades by overworking or doing too much or not thinking about your boundaries or even the boundaries of the other people around you. It's important that you're not a shapeshifter who changes who they are in order to please or keep the peace or let everyone overtake you. But as a talented nine, that is less likely. It means you can be dismissive and yours and other people's boundaries. Oh yeah, boundaries are going to be a big issue for you, because you often do too much for others. Remember, fix their lives, and you end up fixing their life path when they should be doing it themselves, as you remember. You can do too much and not help yourself enough. You can give help but fail to ask for help, and like struggle in silence and not ask others for help. And you've got to balance that. You know, you've got to give and receive in equal measure. You've got to not take over people's lives, not step over the mark, the boundary, because you've got to look after you and they've got to look after them. Remember, you're here just to give them the tools, emotional and mental and physical, to do that. Okay, you're not here to run their life at all. So have the assertiveness to demand boundaries, not only for you, but for the people around you too. Support your life path too. Take care and be aware of, honour yours and other people's boundaries. And know when to stop helping, take care of your own needs. And know when to ask for help yourself. It's not just about you giving out energy. It's important that even though you have a path of service, that you connect with others in a way where you sometimes ask for help from them and advice from them sometimes. That can only help develop your connections for your life path too, anyway. So you're here to serve the leader, the team, the task, and be dependable as well as responsible. Remember, as a nine, you can try and lead a bit, but you're here to be more service orientated. Maybe serve another person as leader. Serve the task, be dependable, and always counted upon to get the job done, get the cogs turning behind the scenes, being a useful member of the team. So as a nine, you naturally work with others well, and you can work hard for the team. You're always willing, you know, to get your hands dirty and get the job done. However, you are strong-minded, and you're better at being the leader, and you might often, you know, find yourself in like mentorship, leadership positions in the group because of your talent in the nine. And you yourself struggle to sometimes cooperate and take what you perceive as orders from others, or stay behind the scenes. So you as a nine can be quite forceful and often maybe not always be dependable to others because of your strength of character and not wanting to cooperate sometimes because you don't feel that that course of action is correct. So you don't feel the need to cooperate. When you're here to be more dependable and cooperative, your leadership could take over and make you want to go your own way and take anyone that will follow you with with you. Support your life path too by prioritizing the service to the team, the family, working together cooperatively rather than leading yourself and influencing yourself. Relax into being a member, an interdependent, interconnected member of the team without needing to lead, fix or influence. You might find that it's quite a nice, more relaxing experience for you, and it will give you a taste of what you're here to be, and that's to be in a team, a group, a family, and be part of the collective, be depended upon, and let people do things for you as well. You're here to be also the tactful mediator of the conflict, you know, helping the team, the group, the family resolve conflicts for the good of the team, for the group, the family. I mean, you're a two. So as a two, you tend to hate conflict and you can run away and hide from it or refuse to deal with it, push it under the carpet, because as a two, you hate dealing with any kind of conflict or negative energy because of your sensitivity. You'd rather push it away and hope it goes away as a two. But you're a nine talent energy, and you can support your life path too by being quite parental, supportive and nurturing. And it gives you the talent to be that supportive nurturer, the parent saying, knocking everyone's heads together, you know, saying, how do you feel? How do you feel? Let's see if we can mediate here. Assertive and strong enough to bring each side of the argument together in a conflict situation, sound everyone out, tell people where they're wrong and demanding a solution. Sometimes you can be a bit hard and some people might get their back up because you just want to get it done, so you're very right. You're this, you're that. Seriously, we should do this, or shouldn't you do this rather than this? And it's you trying to right the situation, but some of the more sensitive among us could get their back up by you. So you've got to remember, read the emotions of others and be a little bit more slowly when you're talking about, when you're communicating in a conflict situation, or, you know, you've got to understand and empathize with everybody's side of the conflict, and only then can you then work towards the solution to that. And sometimes as a nine, you can be a bit, yeah, whatever, this is all like below, and it's not that you feel it's below you, it's just you're like, can't you just get on with it, you know, kind of energy. And the nine needs to be a little bit more compassionate and empathetic with those kind of situations, and it helps you manage conflict and be that mediator that you're here to be. So support your life path too, work at keeping your personal feelings of any conflict situations out, and use your nine wisdom and calm to develop towards tactfully mediating the team, the group, the family towards sensible resolution without disregarding anyone or making anyone feel like they're disregarded, or, you know, because remember, the nine can be a bit, and people can get their back up a little. So gentle yourself down, expression nine, so that people feel that you're really listening to them. You're here to learn to plan the next steps after the initial idea. The one has the idea. The two is all about taking that idea and starting to planning how that will be manifested. And talking to the right people, pulling the right people, the team members together in order to help you achieve that idea that the one has come up with. The energy of the two is the nurturer of ideas and the builder of teams, the nurturer of ideas, if I can say that word properly, and the builder of teams. So you're going to struggle with that. So you might find that you might struggle to focus on ideas and struggle to make plans. You might have the idea floating in your head, but you never action it. You never nurture the idea or the situation or take it further. That's the struggle of the two. Your nine talent energy means that you are already a talented planner and a team builder. You know, you've got all that ability within you. You're also a thinker, an intuitive, multi-skilled, a generalist, able to communicate and influence well and influence teams. In fact, more like a leader at times. So try not to take over in that form. Be part of the planning and team building and working process. Get involved, help your life path too by getting involved with the initial planning steps of the task or project. Use your extensive leadership talent and competence to approach the right people for the right job in the team and, you know, see if they would like to do it, but try not to lead too much. It's hard to use your talent in the nine without overstepping the mark with people, and that's going to be part of your job to sort out, because remember, you're here to plan, but you're here to team build, not to team lead, and, you know, to be part of that group that brings that idea towards expression. So getting involved, assessing others, but ensuring that you're always cooperative and you're always looking at the team and having two-way conversation, and you're not just acting on your own devices. That's important. Because you've got to give yourself your own kudos as well, though. Remember that inner compass that I keep talking about, because sometimes twos can judge themselves on what other people say about them or what others think of them instead of going within for validation. And because the two is here to connect with others and deepen relationships with others, they can sometimes rely on the opinions of others far too much and make decisions based solely on what they want without even considering their own needs. The two needs to develop their inner compass, turn inward for validation, and do what you think you are going to do. Not only do you use your intuition to help and assess the needs of others, you've got to also use it to feed your inner compass and your ability to make independent decisions and feel that you're able enough to do that, because you are. Your nine talent gives you that power and confidence inside you already. Powerful dominant energy as a nine. You have a strong inner compass fueled by your own intuitive wisdom, and that is great, but it can be overpowering at times, but useful for your life path too. This gives you a very strong basis for your own independent decisions. So use your strong inner confidence and inner compass that you already have from the nine energy to help you trust your own judgment implicitly and act on your own intuitive feelings to support your life path too. I hope you've really enjoyed my video today. So if you want a reading, please email me or contact me on social media. You might be interested in my tarot channel. So look for my Soul Explorer brand and you'll find my tarot channel. Or you might want to request a video or just send me questions. Or anyway, I'm going to put some links in my description box for my books and my Udemy courses on the internet, on Udemy. So you can contact me if you need to and ask any questions. I hope to see you soon in my next video. And if you haven't already liked this video, please like and subscribe to my channel. So I hope you've enjoyed listening to my video today. And just before I go, I just want to let you know some exciting news. My beginner book, Remember Your Life Plan, has just been released on Amazon. And this gives you a basic grounding in numerology. It's for beginners and people that are just starting out. And it's good for you to read this before you read my other books. So Remember Your Life Plan is for beginners, really. Gives you a grounding in numerology, and it's sort of the level where people would do my foundations of numerology practitioner on Udemy. So that is my first beginner book, and it's just for newbies. This one is for people that are more intermediate. It provides a deeper analysis of the lessons and challenges of your life path and birthday energies, a concise list of your priority and secondary life path tasks, and it gives you a deeper understanding, and it's longer and more detailed analysis for potential numerology readers. And then Remember Your Talents, again, it's an intermediate level course, and it provides an analysis of the lessons of your life path with your talent number, with your expression number. So it shows how good you're going to be at achieving the lessons of your life path and birthday number. Again, a lesson by lesson comparison of your talents to see how easy or difficult each task in your life purpose will be. And again, it's longer and more detailed, and it's more for numerology readers that have a good grounding. And if you have a good grounding, you might want to take my Master Practitioner for Readers on numerology, if you prefer audio visual or you'd like to do both. Remember Your Motivations is due out soon. I'm working frantically to try and get this third intermediate book of the trilogy out there for you, and I hope to do that soon. So And don't forget, for if you want a reading from me one-to-one over Zoom, just send me an email. You might want a one-to-one, an ongoing one-to-one service, in which case you might want to join my channel on YouTube. And if you live in the UK or you're visiting soon, I do shows all over Oxfordshire and Buckinghamshire and Berkshire sometimes, with Dear Spirit events. So come to one of our events for a personal reading, or just say hello and purchase one of my books. It's completely up to you. So these are my three books, and I hope you've enjoyed my video today. And get looking on Amazon, because I tell you what, to find them quickly, put my name in, Katie Ewers, KatieYoueRS, and then my books come up straight away for you to have a look at. So I hope you enjoy my books, and I hope you've enjoyed my video today. See you soon.